service and labour, 0.5% of the net salary will be deducted by the employer every month. The directive affects both public and private workers. The move is in line with the government's decision to implement more subsidies for this scheme, which has been grappling with shortage of sufficient funding. However, some say they have no issues with the deduction, but with the directive that gave no room for discussions. This was a surprise to many because no one has discussed this with us. This is a good move because it is for the benefit of all Rwandans, but they should have discussed this with us. For them to just say this and expect it to be approved immediately is what I have an issue with. They should have talked to us before so that we can also have a say in this, because at the end of the day, we are all our neighbor and brother's keepers. Some civil society organizations have called that this decision be put to a halt and room given for consultations.
Hari n'ababa bafite inguzanyo za banki, hari ibintu binyuranye umushahara ubukora, bisabwa rero ko umunyamushahara abagomba kugira uruhare mu cyemezo nk'akiriya iyo kijya gufatwa. Bityo rero twumva ko ari bikwiye ko minisiteri yakwe kubiretse gushyira mu bikorwa kiriya cyemezo, hakabanza kugishwa inama abakozi ariko mu buryo buri direct, ibyo twita direct consultation. Bitanyuze gusa kuba bahagarariye, kuko burya n'abakozi baba bagomba kugira ibitekerezo batanga ku buryo bw'imbona nkubone.
The Ministry of Public Service and Labour, however, says that this information was shared with all relevant institutions beforehand, and this should have trickled down to the employees.
Buri muntu ku giti cye nibaje bamubaza.
We cannot say that we talked to so and so, but because that will take a long time. But we talked to various institutions and representatives of all these employees, and we expected them to have held these discussions already and for the employees to have this information at hand. An advisor at the court of Rwanda, Bichamumaka Dominico, says that even though this is a humanitarian act, issues like salary increment should also be looked into, especially for civil servants if the government relies on them for such issues. The main problem actually lies in salary scale. An employee still earns what they earned back 10 years ago, yet everything has changed over the years, including food prices. So this would not be fair to them. It would only be fair if also this moved hand in hand with an increment in their salaries. So this should be looked into. The ministry, however, says that this should not be an issue for civil servants specifically, as they are given a horizontal promotion every 3 years. This order is expected to be implemented this month.